Okay, I'm here in my garage again, and I'm making this video really more for me than anything else to kind of keep my thoughts straight. You can see here some decals that I've ordered off eBay. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with them yet, but I thought they looked pretty cool, so I wanted to go ahead and order them just to have them on hand until I decide what I'm going to do here. But basically what I'm going to do is we're going to have a different color scheme on the bike. It's going, the bike for sure, this is going to be painted a light gray, a light to middle color gray, like what you would see on an aircraft. Okay, my original intent was I was going to, and I still am going to do this, I want to have a, since this is a Japanese bike, I want to have a theme to make it look like old World War II Japanese Zero Navy fighter. Now, the Japanese Zero basically came in two colors back in the 1940s, a light gray or a dark army green. I researched both, and really it would be really difficult for a layman to do the green, and you really can't find gear as far as helmets and stuff like that in that color. And since, as you can see, I already have gray helmets from my old motorcycle, I decided we're going to go with the gray. So you can look at the helmets and get an idea of what color we're going to go with here. And at first I was going to, if you've ever seen a Japanese Zero fighter, they were gray and they had the Japanese rising sun, which was basically, you can see it here, you could either have the rays or go without rays. That's the Japanese flag, just has the big red dot or zero, whatever you want to call it, as their flag. Well, anyway, I was going to do this all in gray, and then I was going to have a large zero right here, and then I was going to remove the logos and just store them. But when I was at the cycle shop today, Scott, the mechanic there, said that there, and obviously you can see it here, there's a little ridge right here. I did not realize that was there. I just thought that there would be two holes. So now that I've thought about it, I think what I'm going to do is we're going to paint the logo red, and then we're just going to have a smaller zero back here. I think actually that, ooh, come back here. I think actually that would look better anyway. Having a red logo against a gray tank and then a red zero, I think that would look much better. And then what I'm going to do here as of right now, these will all be removed, and I'm going to have bullet holes across the top. I'm sure you've seen the bullet hole stickers. Anyway, that's what we're going to be doing there. Also, the side covers here for sure will be painted gray, and don't know if I'm going to keep this logo here or not. As of right now, I'm going to say yeah and do something in this area here, and then just paint the logo red and keep the logo red. That's the idea I'm going with right now. For sure over here, we're going to leave the logo on here. I haven't decided if I'm going to use the logo or not. I'll decide that further down the road. But anyway, that's where we're at with the paint job. We'll call this the Suzuki Zero paint job part one. Just laying out my plans. One more time, we'll take a look at the stickers. Now, anything I use that I apply on there, I will have to not only use the backing of the decal, but also I'll have to put a little bit of resin on the back of it, and then after it's painted, it'll have to be clear coated, so there will be a protective coating over the zero decal that I put on here. But anyway, and the look I'm going for is I want it, this is an antique bike. So I want it to look like an antique, which means, and I've been trying to explain this to my friend Michael Blackwell without success, what my thinking is here. I want I like old looking stuff. That's why my motor, other than cleaning it up, my motor is going to stay looking just like that, because I like things that look old. I'm old. So my equipment should be the same as me, old. Anyway, I'm not really that old, but still. I like motorcycles that look like they're actually ridden. I don't want my motorcycle to look like some $25,000 bike that gets hauled on a freaking trailer to Daytona twice a year for bike week. That's not what we're looking for here. I want a bike that looks like it's ridden every day. So anyway, that's what I have planned so far. As soon as I get started, we'll do a part two. Thanks for watching.